It's like going at a diagonal, and it warps through the game, and it looks all glitchy, and it's freaking weird. And then also the hostages that you have to save in order to beat stages start despawning, which means that you cannot finish the stage. So either I need to find another ROM, or not speedrun the game on that difficulty level. I'm kind of curious about that. Maybe I'll take a look at it on my Genesis and see if something similar happens. Like, maybe it's the emulator that I'm using. I don't know. That thing that appeals to me about Shadow Dancer, out of all of the games that I run, it is an entertaining speedrun, and it's also very short, whereas everything else I seem to play is very long. With the exception of Hotline Miami, but I don't know, it's not really that great a speed game. It's just a lot of... it's a lot of fun. I have no desire to improve on my PB by any enormous amount. I mean, you know, like, getting improvements there would be cool, but there's so much bullshit in that game that it's, I don't know, almost not even worth it. I should get back to racing that, though. Because it is fun in a race context, I think. I think with racing, it's less about... I mean, it's never about a good time for me. It's just about kind of having fun. And, hopefully putting a... on a interesting show for viewership and that kind of thing. You know, set up that multi-twitch and hope that the times are close or something. Yeah. I mean, it's just one of those things where it's like, oh, I'm having a great run, and then this guy decides to react way faster than he normally does. And you're like, why would you do that? You've never done that in this room ever, you jerk. And sometimes it's something you can deal with, but a lot of the times it's just sort of like, they just turn and shoot you right away. Like, oh, okay. Surprising. There are substantial differences between Cave Story and Cave Story Plus Miranda. So for a start, and one of the reasons why this is more of a popular game to run than Cave Story Plus, is that the games have a difference with regards to how many frames a second the game runs at. So there's a lot of cool tricks and stuff like that that are in Cave Story that are not in Plus just because of the frame difference. Yeah, 10 FPS higher. There are some tricks that you can still do, like, for example, the Shaco House Skip. You can't do it the same way, but you can still wind up doing it. So how we do the Shaco House Skip is you take damage from the bat, and then it drops. You take damage from the bat, and then you open the pause menu. And then when you open the pause menu, it resets Quote's invincibility frame, so you can take another damage boost off of the bat. And that helps you clear a substantial amount of distance vertically. So you can't do it that way. Oh, I don't know about this. Oh, wow. Basil almost had me for breakfast. Yuck. Not a great fight. Aw, the game is telling me it still loves me. Or still loves to kill me, one of those. Yeah, the difficulty that I have with mashing is with combining other inputs with mashing. So like, if I'm trying to hit jump with my thumb at the same time that I'm mashing, it just goes right in the toilet. But, you know, if it's something where I can like stand and just mash with the one finger, then it's decent, you know, it's pretty good. Unfortunately, I need to use my other hand to aim down while I'm in the air, so I can't use that. I'd have to have like a really weird grip. And it's something where it's like, okay, I don't even know if this would be better than what I'm doing currently. I am getting slowly better. So it's a case of, okay, do I completely change the way that I hold the controller for mashing and have to practice that from square one, or do I just work on what I'm currently doing? And continue to practice with that, because it is getting better. Despite the fact that I lament about it constantly, which I'm sure is annoying, so I apologize. That was quick. Nice. Okay. think I'm lucky to have Fireball level 2 right now. I'm not happy with how the drops fell out, and I'm also not happy with my weapon management and shooting there. Finally, I hit that guy. My jelly kill is getting a lot more consistent. How much RNG in speedrun? Give me a minute. I need to do something I'm terrible at. So. Yeah, so what the enemies drop in terms of like these little Dorito things, or EXP, and also hearts and all this kind of other junk. Come on. So that's the Shaco House Skip, and I am bad at it. Ooh, groovy. Kind of. I mean, most of the RNG as it relates to the drops and that kind of thing is more likely to come up closer to the beginning of the run. It's really important in Egg Corridor, so like in the first 6 minutes or so, but outside of that, drops for the most part aren't that bad. Clever damage boost? Yeah, no, it's really cool. Think about how impressed you would have been if I had done it correctly. Oh my god. Don't land on me. I saved time. Oh my god. That is something I just absolutely hate. It's like, wow, that split sucked. Oh, hey, look, you saved 4 seconds, and it's like, no. No, I don't want to save 4 seconds on that split. Are you kidding me? Poop. These drops suck. But it's okay. I don't know. Yeah, I think it's not so much reading too much into the comment. I think people like to complain, myself included. Wow, 114, that's pretty sweet. You just stay right there, Mr. Frog. I'm going to use you for a damage boost. I'm gonna kill your friends. Nice. I'm right in front of the door. Okay, I've been kind of screwing up this boost lately. And that's much, much better. I do love the music in this game. I mean, it's the same thing when I play La Milana, right? I should be getting experience on this. I'll get some on the way back through this area. I'll just farm the drops and get level 2 missile launcher, because I really want to have that. But yeah, I talk about coin drops, I talk about the experience drops, that sort of thing. Not always complaining, but more, I don't know, just from a commentary perspective, that that's something that I'm paying attention to. Seven and a half seconds, though. Pretty sweet. Sub 2 minutes for that split. It's totally arbitrary, but it feels good. No, I have to go this way. There we go. Level 2 missile launcher. My favorite. Just like Ma used to make. Please don't kill me. Whoa. I almost ran head first in that jelly. You know, like I'm running head first into everything else. Whatever. Little slow, but I have 11 health, which should be plenty for the fight with Curly. And all my weapons are at a level or experience. That's good going into Sand Zone. Oh man. It's hotter than a Bantha's ass in here. Sundown in my apartment is like an oven. Because you've got the sun bearing into my windows, and then all of the windows of the people that live below me. And he, of course, rises, so... yeah. The opposite of that, though, is that when it's in the wintertime, I generally don't have to heat the place as much. Because I tend to get heat from apartments that are below mine. Is convenient, but... I didn't want to ride the bug anyway. Oops. Kinda lost track of Curly in that fight. and of my fireball usage. I think I may have done that properly. What? I was expecting him to jump and then he didn't. That's kind of bad. Yeah, the way over was pretty good, but then the way back was sort of shoddy. Missile usage was suspect. The reason why you want to really kill those Polishes with missiles is because when you kill them, they break into a ton of little tiny ones. Wow, those drops. Very nice. Excuse me, Pooch. Oh well. I kind of wasted a little bit of time with the dog there, but it wasn't too bad. Because on my way back I managed to get the enough experience for level 3 on my missile launcher. So as long as things don't go weird, I should be able to save time from a not having to farm crap kind of perspective. Wow, I'm here quickly. These birds are kind of random in terms of their flight pattern. So when you get hit in this game, you lose experience on your currently equipped weapon. And because I want to continue flying, if I'm likely to take damage, I'll just switch to another weapon. And then hopefully take the damage on that. Ideally, I want all three of my weapons at this point to have level 3 for the boss fight against Toroko that's coming up in a little bit. But, yeah, you know, like, I can take a couple of hits without it being too bad, or losing anything at this point. I'm gonna go get the heart one now. Zenry! Absolutely, it's important to dispense with the pleasantries. I'm doing quite well. I had a really good run of Cave Story right before this one. I was on very excellent pace, but things did not go well in the last split of the game. Had a few deaths and wound up getting... finishing the run about 5 seconds behind my current splits. So, no PB, but... but it was a good run. I felt pretty good about it. And this one also, at least for the time being, is looking up, so... Yeah. Thanks for tuning in, and enjoy your lurking, I suppose. Yeah, I was way ahead. Maybe... I don't know, like two and a half, three minutes, somewhere in that kind of range. Did I collect any extra experience on my missile launcher? I don't think I did. How many missiles do I have? 10. Having a buffer on it would be really nice, but I don't need it, and I shouldn't be aiming to take damage on it during this fight anyways, because when you use the missile launcher, you're not really at any major risk of getting hit by Toroko. So, yeah, and I've got 10 missiles, so this should be fun. Watch a movie with your lover. Ooh la la. Alright, well, enjoy. I need a better picture for this split. Get him, King. I believe in you. I guess I didn't believe hard enough. Some shots with the machine gun there, so I missed out on the opportunity for a little bit of DPS, but overall solid fight. Splat. So these two runs are teaching me that, one, I have an enormous amount to improve upon, and two, I am actually getting to that point where I am improving upon. Which is to say, I'm definitely at a level where I can get a decent PB. You would drop something else. Seriously, these guys drop a ton of experience. Thank you. A little bit of a slip up there, but nothing major. It's the wrong weapon. Damn. Doctor, you have to help me. Damn it. This is going to be a slow fight. Bad split, bad fight. Yeah. Thank you. Not quite doing this fight fast yet. I should be able to kill him before he touches the ground after jumping. But at least I'm not getting eaten anymore. If Balrog actually catches up with you, he'll have quote for lunch, literally. Well, I didn't lose level 3 machine gun, so that's good. What? Are you... Interact with the goddamn console, quote. Fuck's sake. This was pretty garbage. Not my best lab end by a long shot. I lost my level 3 in a very inconvenient position. I got it back rather well. But then after getting it back, I stuck around to get safety EXP. And then lost it again. It's not ideal at all. Damage to this guy with my knife, I think, is the biggest problem I'm having with this fight right now. You! I won't lie, I'm pretty choked right now. Get out of the way, dude. Okay, I'm only going to be losing about 20 seconds, I think. I can get into the water right away. Okay, good. Man, this fight. Why am I so bad at this fight? I mean, I'm not even struggling with the really difficult parts of doing this fight quickly. I'm just struggling with the dumb crap. Oh, only 12 seconds. Alright. It's not too bad. Thought it was worse. All right. I suppose given how I've been doing the core fight lately, 12 seconds behind isn't too bad. Plus, from what I remember of my PB, that segment was actually pretty good, or one of the best fights I'd had of core to date. So, on the one hand, it's kind of like, okay, it makes sense that I'm struggling to beat that, but there's definitely a lot of slop there that could be improved on. I can see it. I just have to, I just gotta make it happen. Do you know why they call him Ironhead? It's because he has iron on his head. Wow, dude. Yeah, that's, there it is. Quite sure what combinations of buttons led me to where I was right there, but sure. This isn't full speed, but I'll take it. Or maybe it was full speed. I think this is my favorite song in the game, or could be, in contention for it. At least from the perspective that it is awesome. Okay, maybe not that awesome. Like, I think it really fits the atmosphere.
Okay.
I wasted a little bit of time there to get a level 3 machine gun back, but I don't think it was that bad. I didn't spend that much time to get it. And it's certainly time that I'm going to recover by having it. Than not having it. It is going to be something to watch out for, though. In the Ma Pignan fight, I'll have to try and see if I can hang on to it. Should have good health here. I haven't been paying attention to it, but yeah, I'm fine. Bonk. Huzzah, I'm a member of the Mushroom Club now. I have a special badge and everything. Yes, I'm going to eat you. Decent fight. Not the best, but decent. Could you imagine if I clipped that large mushroom and lost level 3 machine gun? I would be pissed. Confident getting a machine boost through here, so I'm just going to equip another weapon. Like the Penguin Club. I don't know what sort of stuff goes on in the Penguin Club. Is the Penguin Club adults only? If you know what I mean. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I knew that thing was going to be uncooperative. Jack-o'-lantern. Yeah, missing those is kind of a pain. I feel certain that the projectiles are more predictable than I think they are when I'm fighting it. When I watch other people play, it feels so much easier to predict where they're going to fire. But I think I probably need to do the boss fight a lot more to really suss that out. No, I want to equip this. Endgame again. Let's see if we can do a little bit better this time. This is super goofy, but whatever. I think I have the experience I need, maybe. Okay, fine. I can recover. Doing this again. Yeah, there's a way not to get hit by the wrench, dude. I think Magma Peach does it in his PB. For Kara Blaster, if that's what you're referring to, which I think you are. Decent fight, and it ended in a position that was pretty good. I I'm surprised I actually gained that much time there because of all of the shenanigans I did trying to get good experience, and then also the extra hearts that I picked up in Final Cave. So, yeah. Oh, don't bump me that way, damn it. So, I think that's more how that fight is supposed to go, rather than how I've been doing it lately. Suck it, Doctor. Should be fine, but I'm going to scoop up some of these for safety. No. The fall of shame. Yeah, I love that too, Drek. Particularly when the ads never fail to load. No. Get back here. Something is trying to eat my leg, and I can't do anything about it right now. Anybody have deja vu? He took the hit on the dude? I've seen him get past that thing without getting hit. So, I guess it wasn't on his PB. Fascinating. Oh wow, I have lots of missiles here. Cute. think that should be enough. Provided I get the experience from the thing. Damn it. Not gonna take the damage boost here, because that gives me slightly more health going in to fight Balos, and that means that I can go through his first phase without using the health pot. Damn. Missed it. Oh, I almost had it. Die, bats. You don't belong in this world. I only have level 2? Oh, shit. This is bad. Huh. So I think a good chunk of that time loss there is because so when you get to one of those block things that you shoot and then it has the timer and then it blows up. If you have level 3 missiles, you can actually blow up one, and then some of the missiles find their way through the wall, and then they'll hit the barrier past that, so you basically set off both of them at once. But because I didn't wind up with level 3 missiles, I had to detonate that one after the first one had fully blown up, and then I moved into the next room. So that cost me some time, and it probably also cost me a little bit of time, maybe, you know, like a second and a half or something like that, on Balos, because having level 3 missiles for the kill is really good. Thanks, Chaos. Yeah, I finally managed to cobble one together. A lot of room for improvement. I think the cool thing here too is that, I mean, all of the gold splits just mean that I'm getting more and more well practiced, and I'm finding time to save off of my personal bests, and I'm improving and all that sort of stuff. So, for me, speedrunning is about that personal improvement. So getting golds is pretty cool. But you know, getting a new PB is I think the culmination of all of that. You know, when you manage to put together all of those getting better and all of that practice and all of those gold splits, and you put them into a single run, you wind up with a good time. I have to say as well, I'm starting to feel eminently decent at this game. I mean, you know, train wrecks are still something. What did I do, like, last week? Like a 116? Not last week, it was a couple of days ago. Yeah, I did like a 116 or something like that, so... But I think train wrecks happen to everybody. So, not something to get discouraged over. Choo choo. Damn, now I'm gonna have to come up with a new goal. I suppose some 104 is the next logical progression. I picked 105 because it was that nice round number. But from here on out, I think getting improvements is going to be more challenging than it has been previously. I'm going to have to make sure I really get like a solid... what do you call it? Solid grass town. That's a big thing that I need to practice. And then maybe I should start doing some of the more challenging machine boosts and that kind of thing that I was talking about earlier. Sub 1 hour? I don't think I'm ready for that yet.